Hi folks, it's the author Angela C. Nurse here. I hope everybody is well. Isn't the weather glorious? Well, at least it is where I am. I've just come back from a fortnight's holiday in my camper van. If you follow me on any social media, you'll see I've been posting up some pictures of some of the beautiful places I've been in the north of Scotland and in Skye. So this video's earrings, quite appropriately, are these little silver sheep. And I saw plenty of those on my travels in the last couple of weeks. Now, it completely was my intention whilst I was away to get stuck into writing book four. I thought I'm gonna have loads of time where I'm not gonna have a lot of Wi-Fi, and so doing work on book, finalising from book two and doing stuff on book three probably wouldn't have been as easy. I thought I'm gonna get some serious words in. But in reality, that didn't happen. Because I found once I got away that actually I was really in need of a break. I was really in need of a rest. My husband and I, we've not had a holiday for a couple of years. Obviously last year was a wipeout for most of us, but it's been pretty just over 2 years since we've had a holiday, and I think we both really needed it. But the interesting thing about that is that creatively, I found that I got a lot of ideas whilst I was away. And I think that's because creativity needs to breathe. It needs space to kind of move around your head and just kind of permeate in there. I'm not a big believer in writer's block. I think that you can't wait for inspiration, because inspiration will let you down. I think routine and dedication get you further, and just sitting your bum in the chair and getting on with it. But I do think creativity does need room to grow and breathe in your head and your ideas. And one of the amazing things I saw was we went to this wee village called Shieldaig. And Shieldaig, you go along what is mostly a sort of narrow or single track road. Part of it follows the train line there, which I imagine would be a beautiful train journey. And you end up in this really pretty little village. So we went for a lovely walk there. And one of the things I saw there was kind of a bit of a rundown cottagey building. The roof was a bit gone and the windows were boarded up. And in one of the windows, like just leaning against the boarding, was a frame of like a proper Victorian style-y mirror. And that really piqued my interest. And I was like, oh, that's quite cool. I feel like this building could feature in book four. And that was really exciting. Now, obviously, for logistical reasons, I will probably move that building somewhere closer to Cuddyford and into Fife, where Rowan is and where she's going to be doing most of the case for book four. Although I have to say, I would really love to do a book where Rowan travels to Skye or the north of Scotland, if for nothing else, so that I can get a wee research trip out of it. So yeah, so maybe that'll be on the cards in the future. So book four, I didn't make any progress with in terms of words, but in terms of story and ideas, I definitely did. We also visited this place called the Well of Seven Heads, which I love it when places have really weird names like that. And that kind of got me thinking that would make a really good book title, or like a play on that make a really good book title. So maybe there's something else in there for another day. Maybe for Rowan, maybe for somebody else, who knows. And the other thing I have done recently is released to the world the book cover for Sally in the Woods. I absolutely love this cover, and I think I've gone on about this quite a bit in previous videos, but I think this cover is stunning. So I was really excited to release it to everybody. I showed it to my newsletter subscribers on the 1st of July before I went away, and got some really lovely comments back, which was fab. And yesterday when I did the big reveal for the cover, I got some fabulous feedback as well, which was great. So I'm really looking forward to having that physically held in my hands to add to my stack of books. And I'm excited to be able to announce soon the publication date and pre-order date as well. That's all for today, folks. I look forward to speaking to you next week. Thank you, as always, for spending the last 5 minutes with me. If you have enjoyed this video, please like and subscribe. I really do appreciate it. Have a wonderful day, and I will see you next week. Cheerio!